Hello everyone, this is Funny. You are watching Funny HS Info. Today I am going to talk about power tool safety. Power tools are used in nearly every industry. Unfortunately, the popularity and availability of power tools make it easy to forget just how dangerous they really can be if not used or maintained properly. Some common causes of power tool accidents are inattention through repetition, inexperience, overconfidence, and occurrences of unexpected event. It is crucial that everyone in workplace is aware of potential hazards of using power tools, as well as being competent at using the required tools. The types of power tools. Power tools can be powered by gasoline, electricity, compressed air, hydraulic pressure, or explosive powder. The most commonly used power tools in constructions are electrical power tools, power cutting tools, and pneumatic tools. Electrical power tools include various types of drills, saws, hammers, grinders, cords, and plugs. Some of the common injuries are heavy, even fatal, electrical shocks, electrical flash burns, eye injuries from loose or broken particles, and cuts or punctured flesh. Cutting tools includes various types of power saws. When operating a power saw, always secure material being cut. Pneumatic tools are the tools powered by compressed air. Compressed air can be blasted out at extremely high speed and present its own set of safety hazards, along with the hazards already inherent in fast, sharp, and powerful tools. Let me brief the safety practices for using power tools. Always read operating manual. Make sure you are wearing personal protective clothing and equipment appropriate for the tool and hazard. Always select right type of tool for the job. Make sure tools and components are well matched. Always inspect tools for damage before use. Never use a faulty tool or component. Disconnect the tools from power source before replacing and adjusting parts, cleaning, or maintenance. Make sure all guards and safety devices are in place and working before operating a power tool. Never alter or remove any safety features. Never leave tools on the floor in high traffic areas. Be sure that the tools are not left where cords or hose may be caused a tripping hazard. Operate power tools only when it is safe to do so. Make sure protect against all possible hazards. Ground fault circuit interrupters are required for electric power tools operated outdoors or in wet or damp conditions. All electrical tools and accessories must be properly grounded or double insulated. Do not overreach when operating a power tool. Overextending leads to various accidents. Make sure tool feels comfortable. Avoid awkward body positions. Never use excessive force. Remember that some power tools pose vibration hazard. Vibrations can cause nerve disorders in many parts of the body. Use proper PPE such as gloves that reduce vibration. Always maintain firm grip on the handle. Stand in firm and well-balanced position to avoid losing balance and causing injury or damage. Always review material safety data sheet requirements when using tools with any controlled products or when working around hazardous materials. Always maintain and service power tools according to the manufacturer's instructions. These are the safety instructions to be followed while handling power tools. Let me brief once again. The power tools used in construction pose potentially safe hazards if used incorrectly. Injuries result from the power tools sometimes result in minor cuts, but more often than not, they involve total loss of an entire finger or serious injury or other limbs. Before you use any type of power tool, make sure you have necessary experience, training, and knowledge to use tools safely and correctly. Read operator's manual. Make sure all saws have working guards in place. Remember, ground fault circuit interrupters are required as safety devices for all portable power tools that are used outdoors or wet conditions. Keep a stable and even footing always using both hands while operating. Make sure you are wearing personal protective clothes and equipment appropriate for the tool and hazard. This is about power tool safety. Please don't forget to subscribe and share my videos. Thanks for watching and have a safe day.